going to demonstrate how to set up and use our covert camera CX range. This is obviously the camera that you have seen in our website, and we send the information to you. When you purchase our cameras, the basic model, which is CX range, it comes in a box like this. When you open it, you will obviously have the user guide and the quick installation guide that you can go through it. You will have the camera module with a camera head attached into it. This camera head can come in different length. Currently in here is around 0.5 meter. You will have a charger, which is standard Nokia charger, and you'll receive a battery with it. You may also receive a car charger if you want to install the camera within a vehicle. We can also send a specially modified charger that you can install within the car next to the car battery. The camera length can come in different lengths, say from 4 inch up to 1 meter. The battery, again, we can supply with a better battery for longer life. Again, we can supply those for you. Also, we can supply with external area to boost the 3G signal or GSM signal on the camera you have. The camera, again, this is on a shrink wrap, as you see. It can be fit into hard cases like this or this, which again, there's a minimal charge on top of that. Now, to start the camera, you open the flap in the back. There's a SIM card holder. You get hold of any SIM card from pay-as-you-go or a monthly contractual basis, but you have to ensure that it is a 3G SIM card. You open the flap on the SIM card holder like any other phone. You insert the SIM card into that flap in the right direction and close it. Then insert the battery inside in the right direction and then close the flap with the stick. Stick it in. Now the camera is ready, but it is not on yet. To start up the camera, you have to use the charger provided with it. Whenever you connect the charger into the camera and plug the charger into the mains power, as soon as the power is connected, the camera will start automatically. And that will take up to 2 minutes for the camera to start up. Now, you can wait for an hour or two for the battery to get completely charged as well, or just wait for 2 minutes and use it with the charger all the time. When the battery is fully charged, you can take the charger out and use the camera on its own with the battery inside, and it will operate up to 200 hours standby, and based on the number of video calls you do, it can go up to 2-3 hours of continuous video calls. If I connect the power charger into the camera again, what will happen, the camera will automatically switch off and then it will restart itself, and that will take up to 3 to 4 minutes. The camera is started, and to be able to use it, you have to ensure it's with a long cable to take it off this loop. This loop will not let the digital signal to be passed properly into the camera. Therefore, you open it up. This can be fit into any other devices as extended cable. Now, you can put the camera in a corner, and if you make a video call into this camera, then you would be able to see what's happening in here. Now, to try it, I'm going to do a video call now using my other phone. I activate it and I just make a video call into it and dial in the number, and we select the video call option. It's going to make a call to the SIM card in here, and then the camera should automatically answer it. And then after you see the images and you can hear it, everything is fine. We can disconnect.